Welcome back, everyone. So in our last video, we saw that we added the items for the basic options and also the state change for all those items are also working. Now we'll be seeing how we'll be doing for the text based filter options. One way is to reuse the way we are going for the basic, so let's just copy all those things so that we can reuse it. Okay, so we have that. Let's just go set up items for this. Let's just use it for the text filler as well. So I need to see how we were doing it for the those text filler. So we can reuse the way this was going on. Okay. So there are three things: name, owner name, and address. Let's just add this and value. I guess we can give nothing because initially we don't need any value assigned to it. Just add the translations as well. Okay, we have this now, so let's just reuse the same way what we get for the basic fields. Let's just click this, copy this, text fills. This we need to change. On value change, the position and the value. Index comma value. Okay, and let's just add one more. this as well. One more king we can do is instead of having 5, we can just use one mutable value, and based on the type we can change it. Let's see that afterwards. Now I can do this like a list of a pair of field option and this. A list of pair in which I think that will become more complex. Okay, let's just go with this only, because this will never change, most probably. And if any change required here, we can directly use it. Okay, directly add it, because it's just field states is what we need. I guess we can go with this only. Let it run, and if Kex is done, then we have this to create other things. Create options, all are in range. The last value we can give it. Okay. So these two things is done. We are okay with this. So if I close this, open again, this value regains, which is what I don't need. It only so regain if I click on what apply. But I guess we can keep those values, like what if by mistake user closes it. Okay, let's go with this only for now, and we can have a look afterwards. So I guess for this video we can stop here. In the next video we will be checking on this, like the ranges for all three we'll be doing at once. I need to see how we can do the range one. Okay, most probably I guess it should be a text field. Yeah, okay, let's check it in our next video. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe so that in next video you get to see all these three how we are going to do it.